Hello everyone, welcome back to another week. It's Monday, I think it's the 24th, but I don't know the specific date. It is the time, 7:48 a.m. And as I mentioned in last week's mini vlog, today I have a big, it's not a photo shoot, it's like a filming shoot with Marks and Spencer's, and it's for a little project that I'm doing with them. I say project, it's for like four videos that you guys are going to see on my IGTV soon, just styling up some of their new collections. As you all know, I am quite a fan of M&S, so that is the plan of action for today. I'm going to leave in 10 minutes. Simon has made me this fresh strawberry and banana smoothie, which is currently, he did it with frozen fruit because I put all the frozen fruit in these little Ziploc bags so that we can make smoothies. So it's giving me brain freeze at the moment. It's more like a milkshake. So I'm going to drink that, then head off to the train station. I'm leaving to give myself an hour and a half because I hate being late. Even though it happens to me quite frequently, I hate being late for things. So I'm leaving ample amounts of time today to get there, and if I'm early I'll just go and grab a croissant from somewhere. Now the temperature has really started to creep up recently, so this is what I'm wearing. I've got a vest on, a vest. I can already feel myself getting hot, and that's partly just because of anxiety, because it is like a big thing that I'm going to do today, and it just makes me like So what do I have on? Usual Miss Soma earrings, these two necklaces by Cinco, Cartier watch, vest is old from H&M, it's like a linen, the bra underneath, which you might be able to see, is also old H&M. I'm so sustainable, I was only thinking the other day, I'm really sustainable with my underwear because I barely ever buy new underwear. It's literally like, hey, shush, thank you. Literally like once every 2 years I buy new underwear. That's so gross, isn't it? Bag is Cezanne, and I've got lots of bits in there, like some basics just in case, because on a shoot it's like you need to take loads of stuff with you. And then these chinos, because I wanted something light, I didn't want to wear jeans today. They're by Arquette, and I've got my Veja waters on because these are the ones with the like burgundy colour V, because the ones with the cream colour V have basically been wrecked from Paris. So I'm going to give those a clean up before I start wearing them again. And they absolutely stink as well, which is delightful. I do have a navy blazer over there, which I'm going to stick on over the top. But I think I'm probably going to end up carrying that for the early portion of the journey, because I'm going to be on public transport, which is always fun and hot and stuffy. So I would like to have, you know, ventilation. Right, I am on the set of the shoot. I actually haven't picked you guys up because I'm now on my last and final outfit. These are all the clothes I've been picking from. Some really amazing things. This is a suede jacket, which I might show you guys in a minute because it's insane, but so good. So now I'm in my last outfit, which is typical Emma, white t-shirt and a pair of trousers and trainers. I'm gonna shoot the last one, then we get to eat.
Yeah, no, actually, you haven't got chat skills.
Terrible chat skills.
Never worked with the
Emma. All right.
Everyone good?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Can you give us a clap? Mm-hmm. Clap and John.
Okay.
Tailoring, huh?
Count as in speed?
Yeah.
All right. Tailoring, take one.
Boom.
Action.
Oh, 1 second.
Hold that, not action.
yeah, good for it.
Hi, I'm Emma Hill, and today I'm going to run you through some of the latest... Sorry, I need to just... what I'm going to say, because tailoring is a weird word. Some of the latest...
tailoring pieces.
Tailoring pieces.
Latest tailoring pieces.
We're going to talk about tailoring.
The latest pieces from the M&S tailoring
collection.
Hi, I'm Emma Hill, and today I'm going to run you through some of the latest pieces from the Marks & Spencer's tailoring collection. So as I said earlier, I like to split up my separates. So I've got these beautiful brown trousers on. Sorry, I'm just trying to put my hands in my pocket. I realised I cannot. So I'll do that again, minus putting my hands in my pocket. Almost! In line. Am I okay to buy anything?
Roll on to it.
Now, everything on this rail is available to buy online and in stores now. No pressure on that.
Well done.
Hurry up.
Right, I'm all done. Just finished. I'm at the station now, waiting for the train. Sorry I picked you, ooh that's bright, hang on let me adjust that. Sorry I only picked you guys up quite late, but we were steaming ahead so didn't really have much chance to get any footage done. But anyway, you guys will see the videos, they'll be on the IGTV. It's very bright, isn't it? Oh, okay, could do go down a bit. Hello everyone, it's Tuesday, and today, in literally like 5 minutes, me and Simon are off to our first, I don't know, what would you call it, a work party? Like, it hasn't been long, we signed with Gleam as our management back in May? Was it May? Yeah, beginning of May. And this is a Gleam summer party, which is exciting. And also nerve-wracking at the same time, because I do not like social events and occasions and things. It just makes me feel anxious. I get social anxiety. So yeah, that's where we're off to. And I'm gonna show you guys my outfit. The weather's a little bit, like it's really hot outside, but the sky is black. So I was gonna wear a dress for this because it's like an outdoor barbecue kind of thing. But instead I've decided, as you can see, to go for my usual blazer and jeans scenario. So here is my outfit. So I've got a H&M men's blazer on. It's nice and big and boxy. For anyone who is wondering, or anyone that's asked in previous videos and or on my Instagram, I wear a men's size 38. That tends to be my go-to size when I'm buying men's blazers. With vintage that can vary a little bit, but normally I would start with a 38. Underneath, this is a top which you might recognise from last summer. It's by, I think we're pronouncing it Rouge, R-O-U-J-E. It's the French brand by the Instagrammer Jeanne Damas. I don't know if I've pronounced her name right even, but she's really cool and French, so you know. I'm sure you know the one. Jeans are by Arquette. They are the slim jeans. Got my new espadrilles on. These are the navy ones in the 6cm heel. What else can I show you? I've got Lispex, the last Lolita sunglasses, but they're currently propping up my hair. Cartier watch. Two necklaces are both by Cinco. Haven't got any rings on. Oh, and the little bag. This is the, it's very, very, very similar to Byfar bags. This is a dupe I was referencing in last week's vlog. And this I actually bought in Japan before I even really knew what Byfar bags look like. So that's it. That's today's barbecue outfit. I'm just thinking barbecue. These are not the most roomy of jeans. I might have made an error there. I can always unbutton my button. Well, we have had a travel nightmare. The logistics, well actually the logistics were okay, but was there a power cut or something? And so all our trains were canceled. So we've had to get an Uber and then the DLR and then another train. It's a bit of a faff. I think this might be us. There's a marking. Looks like we're off to a wedding. Looks very grand. So we're at somewhere called Shoreditch Gardens. And I'm excited to see the setup. And I think someone's getting a little bit hangry. They've not eaten all day. Look at how cute. He's run off already, look. He's off over here. He's already doing his thing. Very cute. I think you're walking on the croquet area.
Someone's gone.
Yeah. My own bed. Not that I've been in anyone else's bed, but nothing beats your own bed, right? So, back from the Gleam party, back in time for Love Island. We've just watched Love Island. Now we're getting ready for the bedtime. I feel like I didn't vlog very much at the Gleam party. I knew that was going to happen because I knew I was going to have social anxiety when I got there. I was very, very close this afternoon to saying that I wasn't going to go because I don't like events and big gatherings, in particular when it's industry events like that, which is why I barely ever go. So, A, I'm quite proud of myself for going and that I did actually go and that I didn't bail last minute. But B, I felt massively uncomfortable. And I basically, we arrived. I'm so thankful that I had Simon, like, as my safety net, if you will. But basically, we arrived. I immediately put my camera away because I just felt like, I get that thing where I feel like people are staring at me, even if they're probably not. And it's not in like a narcissistic way, it's kind of in, it's in an anxiety way. So I immediately put my phone, my camera down and was like, ugh. We made a beeline for the toilets, then found my manager, Holly, sat with her, had some barbecue food. Barbecue food was really good, by the way. Kind of enjoyed the venue, but I did not move from my seat. Like, I could have mingled, but it was not possible in my mind. I was like, nope, nope, there are far too many people here that intimidate me. And that's not their fault, that's my fault. I just have to deal with that. So basically, long story short, lesson learnt. I think it was nice to go, but perhaps my rule of no events should stay to no events. So yeah, that's my thought of the evening. Tomorrow is a new day. Morning everyone, it's Sunday. We're out for an early morning walk in the woods.
Bright and early, because it's too hot for the dogs, isn't it?
Yeah, otherwise it gets too hot in this weather. Yesterday was a scorcher. How hot did it get?
My phone said 33.
33. I feel like it was hotter than that.
Not as hot as France, eh?
Not as hot as Paris, no. I feel so sorry for anyone in Paris. So today is fun. We're not going to see the Blue Jays. We're going to see Boston Red Sox versus New York Yankees. So yesterday was the first game, obviously with the same teams. All you Americans will know how baseball works, but I know a lot of British people don't know how it works. But yeah, today is the second game of which we are going. It's going to be hot, and Simon thinks we've got like tickets which are directly set in the sun, so that's going to be interesting. Yeah, so today we're going to go watch the baseball. It's at Stratford, the Olympic Stadium, although I don't think it's called the Olympic, is it called the Olympic Stadium?
No,
it's called the London Stadium, but it's where we had our Grand Olympics once upon a time, back in 2012. So that's exciting, we're off there today. Might take you guys with us, depends. Might just use my phone and film like a few little snippets. I'll probably do more on stories today. Right, we have taken, oh, you've lost it, to making our own smoothies with fresh fruit, look. I'm gonna show you how I organize our smoothies. So I got these. Thank you, that's not helpful, is it? Just, can you pause the blending for 2 seconds while I explain? Thank you so much. Right, so I bought
Oh my god, right.
Honestly, he's gonna get a beating in a minute. So I bought these. Stop touching me! I bought these off Amazon. They are silicone, kind of like sandwich bags, and they can go in the freezer. So these are reusable, so there's no plastic wastage. And I create, can I just say as well, a plethora, if you will, of delightful frozen fruit things in here to make smoothies with. And then when we fancy one, so we're trying to have one every day, we whip out one, stick it in the blender, and blend. Now you can do your job.
Yay.
Go on then, get blending. I don't rate the service for this smoothie house. This is taking forever.
Told you it's too much.
No, it's not too much. Don't blame my portion control. It's your blending skills. It's terrible.
Best one yet.
I hope so. That's mine. Thank you. Good, that one. It's a nice consistency. It's not like the gloop, pulpy yogurt you made the other day.
That one was good though.
This one's better.
Okay, fantastic. Have a great
time. Glad we went today. We went with Simon's auntie. Simon's auntie's wife, but she's still an auntie because they're married. So yeah, Simon's auntie. and it was so fun. I was a bit worried that the atmosphere wasn't going to be as good as when you go to the States, but it was. And we were actually surrounded by a lot of Americans, which helped. So yeah, it was a really fun day. I hope that they put on more of those events over here, but it has given us, like, we've got the bug again to go back to America, so I'm sure we'll end up planning more trips. We've already got some coming up next year, but yes, it was a good day. A nice way to end the week. Now, I'm getting in bed on my own, or with that furry little creature there, because Simon's gone to the airport to pick up his mum and his sister, because they've been in Munich for the weekend. So, yeah, I'm going to go to bed, signing off this week's vlog here, and I will catch you guys. I'm like, what's the schedule like? I'll catch you on Sunday, but I've got no idea what the video's gonna be. So it's like a surprise. So I'll see you then. Bye.